Japanese bombs and shells are bursting in Shanghai. Up the crowded Wangpu Rip, hapless refugees are hastening with salvaged belongings to the comparative shelter of the international settlement. Japan is repeating the swoop on China by which she conquered Manchuria. Latest reports say the Japanese part of the settlement has been bombed by the Chinese themselves. At Peiping occurred one of the incidents seized on by Japan as an excuse to fling her armies at the throat of China. These trucks, she alleges, were bombed as a detachment entered the gate. A third of the Japanese were inside when the surprise blow fell. Quickly, avenging Japan pushed westward. China's warlords prepared to fight. Here are China and Japan. Japan, only 1/15 the size of China, attacked her in 1931 by sending forces into Manchuria. It's Manchukuo now, three times the size of Japan, but since 1933 completely under Japan's thumb. In 1935, Japan marched on and tried to take these five provinces, themselves more than twice Japan's own size. If she acquired these, they will give her domination over 370 million people. The Great China, bordering those coveted provinces, protected the flank of China's 19th Route Army, the formidable divisions that moved up to oppose the invaders' advance. Dynamic Chiang Kai-shek, head of China's government, has created a modern army since his country's humiliating defeat 5 years ago. But at sea, the fleet of Japan rides unchallenged, raining destruction on Shanghai. Naval warplanes are daily bombing the city. This is war in China. Troops of a nation that the world began to know less than a century ago, advancing upon an age-old empire. The smoke of burning villages goes up against the sky, and Japan watches. Is it the rising sun?